Well, it came to me as a big surprise when I saw Grandmaster Diptayan Ghosh in the playing hall of the World Junior Championship. Diptayan, you're no longer a junior, yes?
No, like I'm 1998 born, so like World Juniors, I can't play anymore.
Yeah, so what are you doing here and in Delhi? You are from Kolkata.
I'm studying in the Delhi School of Economics. I'm doing my master's over here, so I thought of coming to the playing
hall. Oh, fantastic. So, well, Diptayan, as we all know, is a super strong Indian GM. What's your live rating right now?
I think it's
25-55, and he was very close to 2600. And so we took this opportunity to actually put him on the hot seat, show him the current positions which are going on. So right now on your screen, you can see the game between Stambouliak, who is white, and Aram Hakobyan. And we are going to quickly give him a lot of game final positions that are on the board right now and ask him what's going on and understand how a strong GM thinks. So, Diptayan, who do you think is better and why?
I think it's more or less equal position with equal material, but since white has somehow like trying to play, I think the plan should be to play Nd2, exchange the white squared bishops and try to go for something like queen f3, a5, a6 and maybe to create something in the queen side. On the other hand, black has like once black's pieces are coordinated, black can try for f5, e4. So it's more or less a equal position, but both sides have their own players.
So it's not drawish and there's a lot of play left.
Yeah, a lot of game to be
lot of fight.
Yeah.
Okay, so you would prefer white or black here?
I think given the current scenario, I would go for black because f5, e4 looks an immediate threat for black. While white doesn't have any immediate plans, it would take some time to like initiate anything in the queen side.
Okay, so here white looks better for, black looks slightly better for Diptayan. Let's go to Kostachi versus Karthikeyan, our very own Karthikeyan. I thought he was slightly worse out of the opening, but what do you think now?
I think
last move was Nd2.
Still slightly worse due to a c5 pawn and like the b6 knight is doing nothing over there. While once the knights e4 knights get exchanged, I think the c5 pawn will always be a weakness for black, and black always has to defend against it.
So guys, notice how a GM is assessing these positions. He thinks white is slightly better here.
Yeah, still.
Okay. Let's go to an important game, Khanin on board number 3 against Pragnananda, who's playing black. What do you think? Not easy, this one. Yeah,
not easy, but like, I don't know, it's black to play and black can play rook c2, I guess, but white has this knight f3, knight d4.
So two bishops versus two knights?
Yeah, like the knight on d6, like black can play bf any time, I guess, and like create if he wants to. I don't know, babe. White also has plans of like rook c2, knight f3 followed by knight d4, and white also has the b file for him, so
slight better for white.
No, like black can even try for bf8, rook d8, and this looks like a
but you need to give an evaluation.
I think I would go for with white.
You'd go for white, slight better for white,
maybe.
Okay. This
I was watching live, and some moves back, black took on bishop h3, which I think was a great decision. Decision. Some moves back, I don't know about d5, but after this, what black played was, I think, very interesting. Now, this was all type of forced moves for both sides. Because if bishop g3, bishop b6, black is clearly better. So now white plan is to play knight g5 and like mating knight is there. So I think this was like a good move by black, sort of. I was also thinking about bishop e6 now. Same plan with queen e8, queen e4, queen b7, bishop d5. I couldn't calculate much, but it looked like that was another possibility for black, and otherwise
you can just then go bg3 and you cannot make the moves. But
bishop e6, I think
bishop e6, queen e4, queen b7, bd5.
Bg3 doesn't work because of knight e5, I guess.
knight e5 you have.
So like after bd6, queen 8, queen e4, immediate bg3, I think black has many options, and bd5 is one of them, d3 is one of them. So okay. I would have played, I think, bishop e6 over here with black pieces.
Okay, that's interesting.
But this is also interesting. And like in this position, like white got the queen out of 8 into the game. So
but he's just taken down, no?
Yeah, but the d pawn is very strong, and like black has many plans. Like even g5, g4 should be one of the plans.
Okay, so you think...
it's unclear, but I don't know. Maybe black should be able to hold easily.
Black should be able to hold easily, not advantage for black.
No. Maybe like compensation. Yeah, like great compensation for the exchange.
Okay, interesting. Let's look at the next one. This was a crazy game.
Arvind Chidambaram. I was looking in the hall.
Where's the queen?
Rook into a7.
Okay. Rook into a7. And so do you think...
I think white is better because of the e4 pawn, and like the pieces are coming to the 7th rank, and if anyone is better, it's white.
Okay. Okay. Actually, in this game, I felt that black had a very powerful move in this position, where he could take rook into e3 and then fe3 and then queen g3. And if you take on c6, then I have queen e3,
rook
f2, queen e1,
knight
f1, e3, yeah. And somehow this was working out. But even in this position, he could just take rook e3, and that's a very powerful exchange sacrifice. But I think Murzin got a great opening advantage, but has misplayed it.
I haven't looked at the opening, but like the from the current position, I think it's...
So you think Arvind should convert this? Okay.
Like slightly better, like with, I don't know, accurate play, black should be able to hold. Like if anyone is better, it's always white.
Slightly better for white. Okay. Drigulo versus Collars.
Yeah, in this game, I didn't understand why it planned to play b4, b5. In some moves back, I think that was sort of inaccurate. Why would you play like b4 and we can...
Maybe bishop c3.
Bishop c3, that's like, I think should be played.
And
bishop
white has c3. Small edge, no? Bishop
yeah,
c3.
At least small edge.
Yeah.
But after, I don't even understand b4, b5 at all. Like, now black has like bishop c5, knight d6, knight c4 and everything. Like,
yeah,
now,
black is doing okay.
Yeah. More than okay, actually. Black can also start like something.
But even a6 is slightly, I mean, not necessary, yes?
No, I think trading off that pawn is good for black, because in some endgames, the white knight might come to c6 and that pawn might cause a problem for black. So it's like, if after exchanging, like black can take any moment on d4, and the b5 pawn for white would be like under attack. So I think a6 is a good move.
Okay, a6 according to you looks good. So finally here
plan what I was talking about is knight d6, knight c4.
Yeah,
like black should...
Okay, bd4.
No, but now b5 pawn is hanging, queen d4, knight b5.
So you think black should be at least okay? But
there was
b6,
no necessary also
b6
to
is
like I think
hanging, right? Oh no, there's...
I don't know.
So like bd4, queen d4, knight
I
b5.
I don't really understand bd4 over here, but...
Maybe just knight c4.
Yeah. In such... Like, I think knight c4, white also has... White has plans like knight c6 and take, and in the end, white takes on d5. So maybe that's why he, like, in to prevent knight c6 out
so
of...
So he took, but I think this will end in a draw.
Yeah, like... Now queen d4, I'm not sure again who is better, because the b6 pawn.
Okay, knight b5, queen b6.
Again, like if anyone, it's rook c5. Yeah, this looks drawish.
Okay, equal. Let's go to board number 8, I think.
How many, like, black is up in so many pawns?
Black is up 2 pawns, so maybe black is just better here,
Like a3 also works, I guess.
So quick, you need to assess quickly.
Yeah, black is clearly better.
Okay, so that's, I think, all. Maybe let's look at two more boards so that we see top 10.
Yeah, this is clearly better for black.
Here, like, Shan Sargsyan looks...
Yeah, like, I saw this white, like, white has a 1 minute left. So, defending this position with 1 minute against a 25, like, 80, I guess, is very hard.
Yeah, what about bishop into h3 now?
Queen into h3.
Or maybe bishop.
No, bishop h3, queen h3, anything followed by vf5 loses the piece.
And if I play queen g2?
Bishop f5.
Ah, bishop f5, just finish him off. Okay.
It's already losing.
So yes. Lost. What about Sri Raghunandan with white against Gazic?
I think this is again a complex position.
Yeah, of course. That's why we've got you. It's
yeah.
complex, so we need the
yeah,
GM.
I think black has good chances with once he plays bb7 and queen e4, anything.
But do you think knight is slightly out of the
game? Like, yeah, knight is out, but this bb7, queen e4 or queen e3 is like a very dangerous threat for black. And like once he moves the white white queen moves, like knight c5, knight e4, is everything is coming.
Okay, so you think
practically
black black looks good. Okay, let's go to the girls section very quickly. Here we have board number one, that's Solakidu playing with black against Mobina Alina Saab.
I think white is clearly better.
White is clearly better. Okay, I was counting the material, but you already assessed it.
Because like the
last move was e5.
Yeah, like the king is very safe for white. Like the pawn on c4 actually doesn't matter, that it's a broken queen side, king side pawn. But anyway, like white has in I think h5.
But what to play now, because f4, maybe g4 or what?
I can take and play queen f4, I guess.
Take and queen f4.
Like once the queens are exchanged, I think white is clearly winning.
Yeah, white has bishop pair and also this
sort
of free-flowing position.
Take queen f4 again, I think knight g6 and queen g5, I think.
Okay.
Better.
Not to forget that white is a pawn up. Okay, next game is Polina versus Vaishali. And Vaishali is white against Polina.
Black is simply a pawn up, I guess.
Black is, yeah.
Black is clearly better.
Just
like
pawn up, yeah.
Yeah, no. Like the immediate plan is to play e4 and rook d7, but I think black can somehow defend it. Maybe knight c4. E4.
You really don't want to play moves like f6, because then knight g6 perhaps.
Maybe knight. I can also knight g6 and then bh3 and some trouble might come.
So you think maybe not
black
so?
Should be like able to defend against that e4 rook d7 threat.
Rook by something like rook c7 maybe?
No, rook c7, e4, b4, rook d8, I'm not sure. Maybe knight c4, e4, knight e5, ed5, knight g6.
So knight c4 moves here, e4, knight e5, ed5.
Knight g6.
Knight g6 attacking the queen. And
but I think white will have some chances, because once the white bishop gets on the g2 g2a diagonal, it's like
also opposite color bishops may come soon, possible.
But I don't think like knight c4 is the only move for black over here.
Okay,
maybe.
let's keep your feel intact. Okay, here you don't need to assess, white already won. Very easy.
White is,
white is winning here. What about here? Anel Afroi is white against
is
Maria Burdnik.
Black is clearly better.
Black is better, even some sack might soon come on g3 with rook h8. What about Arpita Mukherjee, your city mate, yes?
Yeah.
Against Gabriela Antova. Antova is white.
Whose move is it?
It's
black to move.
Black to move, and black is a piece down.
I don't think black has any threat also. Like queen f5 and then nothing, I guess. White can like.
But you know, when the king is open on g2, you feel a little scared.
Like when there are pieces to attack, but here just the rook's on e5 and the queen is sitting on c8, so nothing much, I guess.
Nothing much, yeah? So
maybe
white
can play queen c2 and rook e2 and slowly even improve.
Okay.
I don't see any plan for black in the next few moves. Like if the knight moves, I can play bf2 and trade off the rooks, then it's winning.
Okay, so on deeper inspection, it seems. You know, this is the difference between GMs and retired IMs, is that they look deeper, you know, they look very quickly, deeply into the position. What about. Yeah, she played queen f5, by the way.
Yeah, queen c2 or anything should be fine.
Okay, I think that's all. Maybe the other boards are. Ah, okay.
White is clearly better.
White is clearly better, of course. Knight on c6 and. What about Dinara.Zieva Margaret? Maybe that board is not loading.
Yeah.
But that's thank you so much, Diptayan, for taking us through the games. I think we have a good understanding. And now we'll compare how the games will end based on your predictions. And we'll try to see how how you assess these positions. It was truly impressive how you were quickly getting to the gist of the position. Like here you felt that white should be better.
Like since there are no immediate plans for black and white should consolidate.
Okay, good luck and we hope that you study less and play chess more.
I'm playing the national premier.
Okay, in Sikkim.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll see you in action there.